And let's come up and have a good wiggle. Okay? Shake the stress of the day out of your system. Go, yeah, well done, do you? See, if you can let your cheek, your jaw be really
relaxed. I'm myself doing that at home.
It helps, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yeah,
my
go.
Time. I stopped mid-moon.
Let's do it again. Into T position at the back of the mat, having the vertical one between your shoulder blades and the horizontal one under your head. If that's not comfortable, then just lie down without the bricks, please. Okay. And you can bring the soles of the feet together and let the knees drop out wide, or you can just let your legs be in any comfortable position for you today. Close your eyes if you can. Let your hands either relax on your belly or be a little bit away from you with the palms up. It's all good. And take a nice deep breath in through the nose and sigh the breath out through the mouth. Again, a deep breath in and a big sigh. One nice deep breath in and let it go with a big sigh. And then allow the breath to flow in and out freely and softly. And watch the breath. Watch as it flows in. Watch as it flows out. As you watch the breath, take a moment to notice your body. Notice how your body feels today. Have that awareness of how the body's feeling, and also notice your mind. What is the state of your mind right now? And then gently encourage the breath to be a little bit deeper, a little bit longer. Think about breathing in, allowing the ribs and the torso to expand in all directions. And breathing out, soften and hug everything gently in towards your midline, towards your center, your spine. Okay? So keep that going. So we're going to be doing quite a lot of core work, but not so much the core work that we do separately from other things. We're going to be doing poses that we normally do, but with our core a little more engaged. Okay, so this class is very much about coming to our center and really practicing the awareness so that we are totally aware of what we're feeling within our body, okay, what our mind is doing all the time. And this came to me because I struggle when it gets really dark and cold, as I'm sure a lot of people do. Okay? And I always forget to take vitamin D. And when I don't forget, I'm okay. But when I forget, I get a little bit But the good news is, because I'm so much more aware since the surgery, I would say, I work with a lot more awareness. I catch myself before I spiral into that deep, dark place. Okay? So I noticed this on Monday as I was lying there in bed trying not to get out of bed so I didn't start eating. And I was typing away, but started to feel myself feeling a bit low. So I got up and started doing things around the house, including moving my body, wriggling, jiggling, and I felt so much better. Okay? When you catch yourself, when you are connected to your center, when you are grounded in the present moment, you really know what you need. What your body needs, what your mind needs, what you need to do to get yourself out of that place. Okay, so we're just going to learn to really connect and to work with awareness today. Okay, and then when you have that, I start to practice that whole gratitude stuff. So as soon as I start to feel rubbish, I move my body and I start to practice gratitude. Okay, so maybe you'll do the same today. So let's use our next out breath. Place the soles of the feet on the mat. Roll over to one side if you're lying on bricks and move the bricks out from underneath you. Okay? And then just go ahead and let the legs go straight out in front of you. And take a moment to notice the space between your shoulder blades. And then we're going to do a full body stretch. So as you breathe in, reach your arms overhead, point the toes forward.
and stretch the body out. And notice maybe if there's tightness anywhere, and then start to stretch one side and then the other a few times. And as you do that, maybe you notice one side is tighter than the other. Maybe you want to hold that side a little bit longer. And then when you've done both sides enough for you, use your out breath to bend the knees, bring them into the chest, and wrap your arms across your legs. And you can keep the knees wide if you like, or take them together, and gently rock side to side, again noticing the lower back. Maybe you want your forehead up towards the knees and breathe into the space between your shoulder blades. And then relax the head down, everyone, but I want you to keep your knees up like this, okay? Now I want you to do three pelvic floor lifts. So as you breathe in, let the pelvic floor muscles relax. So keep your feet off the mat, okay? And as you breathe out, you're going to squeeze the pelvic floor muscles in from the front sides and back and lift up towards the chest. And then breathe in, relax again. Breathe out and squeeze and lift. Feel your lower belly drawing in. Breathe in and relax again. Breathe out, squeeze and lift. And then we're just going to relax that and do some hip circles. Okay? I don't know if you noticed, but when you do your pelvic floor with your feet off the mat like that, you can't squeeze your buttocks. I notice sometimes when we do pelvic floors, some people squeeze their buttocks. That's not your pelvic floor. Yeah. So I just thought, give you that for now. And then go in the opposite direction a few times. Lovely. And then inhale, reach your arms and legs up towards the ceiling and rotate the wrists and ankles a few times in one direction. And a few times in the opposite direction. Wonderful. And then from here, bring the knees into the chest. Some of you will start to roll up and down the spine a few times to come up. Some of you will roll to one side to come up. Okay. And then you're going to come onto your hands and knees. Bring your bricks with you. So I'm going to ask you to do a cat-cow. Okay? And I want you to notice your spine moving in your cat-cow, which is going to do three. Okay, so have your shoulders, elbows, and wrists in alignment, knees underneath the hips, and as you breathe in, you're going to send your heart forward, tailbone up, look up. When you breathe out, push the earth away and round the spine. Inhale, heart forward, tailbone up, look up. Exhale and round the spine. Just one more. Okay, we're moving the whole length of the spine, and breathing out to round. And then come to neutral, okay? Grab a brick, and I want you to place the brick in between your shoulder blades, okay? And we're going to not move our upper back. We're going to move just our lower back, move just the hips, okay? So breathing in, send your tailbone up towards the ceiling. Breathing out, draw the belly in, scoop your tailbone under. Breathing in, send the tailbone up, keep the upper back as still as you can. Breathing out, send the tailbone under, draw the belly up. Inhale, tailbone to the ceiling. Exhale and curl. Now we're going to do hip circles, so just the hips, okay? Notice how the upper body wants to move along, and probably there's going to be a little bit of movement, but you want to keep most of the movement in your hips. And then go in the opposite direction a few times. Wonderful. Then we're going to take that brick and place it onto our sacrum, so on the back of the pelvis, okay? And we're going to try to keep our hips now stable, okay? And we're going to move the upper back. So as you breathe in, you're going to melt your chest towards the floor, squeeze the shoulder blades towards each other. As you breathe out, you're going to push the earth away, drop the chin around the upper back. Inhale, melt the chest up. Exhale and round the upper back. Inhale, melt the chest again. Exhale, round the upper back. And then we're going to move our upper back in circles. So it's really small movements, trying to keep the hips stable. Notice if you can do that and then go in the opposite direction a few times. And if you find it really hard to isolate, practice it. Practice it at home. Okay? Wonderful. And then take the brick out of the way. Let's just do a few full body circling away, wriggling. Have a bit of fun with it. Lovely. And we're going to sit back onto our heels. Rotate the wrists. Are we nice and warm-ish? I'm getting there.
Go the opposite direction a few times.
Wonderful, because we're going to come back onto our hands and knees, okay? But watch me a second before you do it. We're going to have the brick on our lower back again, and we're going to lift one leg up, lift the opposite arm forward, and when we exhale, we're taking them out to the side, okay? So I'll do it this side, okay? Lift, bend out to the side. Notice, I'm not doing this. So it's just going to be a little lift, that's fine, okay? So we're doing it with more control, that's all, so that we can be aware of what's going on in our body, okay? So place the brick onto your sacrum again, okay? Have your shoulders, elbows and wrists in line with each other, knees underneath the hips, and think about keeping your spine long, so you're looking a little forward and down, okay? And as you breathe in, lift your right knee up. I forgot to say pad under your knee, so if it's horrible, go ahead and pad. Squeeze the legs in, lift your left arm up. Squeeze everything into the midline, take a breath. As you breathe out, you're going to bend the left elbow, take the right knee out to the side. Inhale back to center. Exhale again, bending out to the side. Inhale back to center. Exhale to the side. Inhale back to center. Exhale, lower down. We'll do the other side. So if you want to pad under your knees, please go ahead. Okay? And let's inhale, lift our left leg up. And as you exhale, stretch your right arm forward. Squeeze everything into the midline as you take a breath in. And as you breathe out, bend your right elbow, bring your left knee to the side. Inhale, take it back to center. Exhale, out to the side again. Inhale, back to center. Exhale to the side, inhale center, exhale, lower it down. And then from here, you can move the brick out of the way, okay? We're going to take our, we're going to be on our knees again for a little while. So if you think about padding, walk back, flip the mat, pad under your knees. I promise you, we're going to be here a little while, it will hurt. Okay, so we're going to come up to stand on our knees and take our right leg out to the side. Am I right? Oh yeah. But we're not gonna come up to stand on our knees, ignore that. Come back down to your hands, but take your right leg out to the side. Wonderful. From here, take a deep breath in. As you exhale, your left arm is going to reach underneath out to the right, and you're going to bring your left shoulder down, okay? And walk your right hand forward, and then hug your right foot and knee towards each other. Spin your chest a little more towards the right and up towards the ceiling. So if your shoulder doesn't come to the floor, you can always rest it on a brick as well. Okay.
What were we meant to be doing, Wendy?
Press into your right hand and spin your chest up a little bit more. Yeah, so you get a nice twist there. Wonderful. And then when you're ready, inhale, bring yourself back up, bring your right knee in. And exhale, step your left leg out to the side. Take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, you're going to take that right hand, reach it behind the left, reach it a long way out until you get the shoulder down. And then you can either walk your left hand forward or keep it where it is, press into your finger pads, spin your chest up towards the ceiling. Okay? And have that sense of hugging your foot and your knee towards each other. Whatever is on the floor, hug them in a little bit. Beautiful. And then slowly come back through center. Fabulous. We're going to do downward dog, but we're going to do a dog wave, and this might not be comfortable. So you might find that you want to do, hold on, let me demo. You might find that you're more comfortable from down dog. You wave forward and lower the knees down rather than holding plank. But everybody else, have a little look, okay? So we're going to go into downward dog. We're going to inhale to come up high onto the balls of the feet. As you exhale, you're going to stay rounded. So tailbone down, head down. and you come forward, and then you extend into plank on the in-breath. As you exhale, you're going to bend the knees and push your bum back into downward dog, and then you inhale, lift again, wave. Just going to do that 3 times. Yeah? So, get your hands in place, use your out-breath, move your bottom back towards your heels and lift up into downward dog. Have a little dog walk while you're there, just bending one knee and then the other a few times. And then when you're ready, as you breathe in, come up really high onto the balls of your feet. As you breathe out, round your spine like an angry cat and come forward, stacking your elbows above your wrists, and then push out through your heels, lengthen the spine, take a breath. As you breathe out, bend the knees, move your bottom back, going back into downward dog. Or you can lower the knees down if you like. Okay? Inhale, rise up high onto the balls of the feet. Exhale, round the spine, come forward, and then lengthen out into plank, take a breath. And as you exhale, bend the knees, push your bum back and up into dog again. One last one, I promise. Inhale, rise up high, and exhale, wave forward. Inhale in your plank, and exhale, lower the knees down. Go back into child's pose, have a little rest. Maybe rotate your wrists out while you're there. Notice what you notice about your body right now. Okay? So if you feel like your shoulders are feeling it a little bit, maybe give your shoulders a quick roll while you're there. And then when you're ready, come on up to kneeling, but this time with the toes tucked under. Okay. So tuck the toes under, come on up and take your hands behind your back, interlace the fingers. Okay. And as you breathe in, draw your shoulder blades towards each other, lifting the hands away from the back. Hug the ribs in a little. Yeah, so if you're struggling to sit back, come up higher, it's fine. Or you can stay there and challenge yourself a little bit if you like. Fabulous. And then let that go. What else am I making you do today? I'm making you do things today. Making you. Okay. So we're going to be on our knees a little bit longer. So please pad under your knees again if you wish. Okay. We're going to come and stand on our knees. And we're going to step our right foot out to the right again. We're going to cross our arms across the chest, okay? And then take a nice deep breath in here. As you exhale, we need to lean to the left. Now, just allow that left side to really shorten for a moment, okay? Then I want you to do something opposite of that. I want you to lengthen that left side and notice how the right side switches on as you do that, okay? So let's do that again. Let it go, let it collapse. And then lengthen it. Can you feel the right side switching on? Now as you breathe in, spin your chest up towards the ceiling. As you breathe out, spin the chest down to the left. Inhale, spin the chest up. Exhale, spin the chest down. Inhale, spin the chest up. Exhale, spin the chest down. And take your left hand down to the floor on the left. And as you breathe in, reach your right arm up overhead towards the left. And then think about grounding into that right foot, reaching with that right hand. Lovely side stretch, I think. And then inhale, come all the way up, swap legs. Are we okay? Okay. So, have you got cramps?
No, I haven't.
Do you want a blanket under your knees then?
I've got okay.
I'll get you a blanket. So you're going to take your left leg out to the left, standing on your right knee. And you're going to wrap your arms across your chest again, like we did on the other side. Okay? And then as you breathe out, you're going to lean to your right and let that right side collapse for a moment. Okay? And then lengthen out that right side. Feel the left side switching on. And then just for a moment, let that go again. And again, lengthen that up and feel the left side. And inhale, spin the chest up. Exhale, spin the chest down. Inhale, spin the chest up. Exhale, spin the chest down. Inhale, spin the chest up. Exhale, spin the chest down and then take your right hand down. And when you're ready, take your left arm up and over, pressing down into that left foot as if you're trying to pull it closer to your right knee. Okay? And stretch it out. Fabulous. And then bring your hands back down. And we're going to go back up into downward dog. So tuck the toes under, take a breath. And as you breathe out, bottom back towards your heels, lift your knees up, go back into down dog, walk your dog out a little bit. And then when you're ready, bend the knees a little, look forward, take a breath in. As you exhale, step right, jump to the front of the mat. And then just hang out in a soft forward bend, allowing your back to lengthen. Tell you what, take your hands behind your head, interlace the fingers. And apply gentle pressure, dropping your chin down towards your chest. And feel that lovely stretch along the length of your back. And then release the hands and use your out breath to slowly come all the way up. So there's a sequence that we do quite a lot in this class where we go from warrior to reverse warrior to side angle pose. We're going to do that now with our hands involved, and then later on in the class we might do it with no hands. Okay? So, shall we step? Be careful with the folded bit, yeah? Step your left leg back, that one. Lovely. And then step your feet wide, okay? And start with the feet parallel. You might want to turn your left foot in a little bit and turn your right foot out to the front of the mat, but keep your chest facing the long edge, okay? Keep your shoulders stacked above the hips. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, bend your right knee into your warrior two. And then bring your arms up. Now have that sense of hugging your feet towards each other. Notice what you're doing with your lower back. Are you dropping the tummy forward, crunching into the lower back? Can you pull the belly in and draw your tailbone down towards the floor? Okay? As you breathe in, left hand goes down, right arm goes up, you lean back. As you breathe out, right forearm comes down, left arm goes up, spin the chest up. Inhale, push into the feet, left arm down, right arm up. Exhale, right forearm down, left arm up and over. One more. Inhale, lift up. And exhale into that side ankle pose. Now hold this one for a moment. Think about drawing your right sit bone under a little bit and spinning your chest up a little bit more, okay? And then you decide with your hand, your left arm like that, can you spin your chest up? If you find that it's not helping, you can wrap that arm behind your back and maybe that will help you spin your chest up more. See what feels good for your body. Lovely. And then from here, we're going to reach our left arm up as we breathe in and bring ourselves all the way up. Straighten that right leg, release the hands down. And spin your right foot in, spin your left foot out. Keep your chest facing the long edge. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, you're bending the left knee without leaning your torso forward. Bring your arms up, hug the feet in towards each other and think about the tailbone reaching to the floor, the belly drawing in and up. And then inhale, right arm down, left arm up, lean back, reverse warrior. Exhale, left forearm down, right arm up and over, spin the chest up. Inhale, push into the feet, come all the way up, reverse warrior. Exhale, into side angle pose, keep the legs really stable. Inhale, come up again. And exhale, go into side angle and we're going to hold it, okay? So can you think about scooping the left sit bone under a little bit, spin your chest up a little bit more, maybe wrap that right arm behind your back if that feels more comfortable. Can you notice your feet a little bit as well? Are you collapsing into the inner edge of your back foot? Can you ground the whole foot down? Are you taking your weight more into your front foot? Can you try and make sure the weight is even in both feet? Lovely. Then from here, inhale, use that right arm, push into the feet, lift yourself all the way up, and then straighten the leg, turn your feet in, and let's have a quick forward bend here. So turn your toes forward, so they are parallel, so the feet are parallel, okay? Hands onto your hips, take a deep breath in. As you exhale, start to go forward from your hip creases. Can you keep the spine long? And then when you feel that's it, not going to go any further, relax the neck. Maybe you want to bring your hands down to the floor, maybe not. Some of you might find you want to bend the knees a little bit. Now notice where the weight of the body is in your feet. Okay? Are you dropping the weight into the heels? Can you bring that weight a little more to the front as well? Lovely. And then bend the knees a little. Use your out breath, press into the feet and come all the way up. All the way up. And then you can either heel-toe yourself back together or jump and land at the knees bent. Have a sip of water before we do more. Okie dokie. What else have I got for you to do? Because it's quite a lot of things in here. Okay, before we do that other thing I want you to do, we're going to do a little twist, okay? You have options if you don't like being here, okay? You can put the back knee down. And if you're going to put the back knee down, pad it, but you can also stay high, yeah? So let's start at the front of the mat. We're going to have our feet are comfortable. The mat's annoying me. Have our feet comfortable distance apart. We're going to take our weight into our right foot. And we're going to step the left leg back and stay on the ball of that foot if you can, okay? And think about pulling that back heel forward and then again, belly in. So look, come forward a little. Pull the belly in, scoop your tailbone under, and then keep the tailbone under, lift your chest back up. Fabulous. Now hopefully you feel the back line. Yes, lovely. We're going to interlace the fingers. And as you breathe in, palms forward and up. Squeeze your inner thighs in towards each other. And as you exhale, next time, lean over to the right. And again, if you're collapsing into that right sideways, can you start to lengthen it a little bit? Now, notice your shoulders. Are they tense and tight here? If they are, maybe bend the elbows. Maybe bring the hands a little forward. Okay? Do what feels good for your shoulders. And then inhale, come up. Bring your elbows to shoulder height. Squeeze your legs together. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale here. As you exhale, lean forward and bring your left elbow to your right knee, palms together. At this point, if you want to lower your left knee down, you can. Okay? Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, spin your chest to the right. So take your left elbow to your right knee, the opposite elbow, that's it. Okay? Lengthen the spine, squeeze everything in. Fabulous. And then exhale next time. Take your hands down to the floor. Step back into downward dog. Have a little dog walk. Are we okay? So from here, bend the knees a little. Look forward. Take a breath. As you exhale, step, jump, or float to the front of the mat. That's great. When people go into a handstand, inhale, come up halfway. And then exhale, come all the way up. Literally, I've seen people float. It's quite amazing. Lewis floats forward.
Yeah, it's that guy's that's new.
Yeah, he doesn't just jump and land. He floats forward. It's quite impressive. Right, let's do the other side. One day I'll get there when I'm about 95. So should we do the other side? Yeah. Take a nice deep breath in, and as you exhale, step your right leg back. Stay on the ball of the foot. Pull the. Did I confuse you, Dad? Pull the heel forward, okay? Again, lean a little forward, pull the belly in, and then draw your tailbone down as you lift your chest up. Interlace the fingers. Now, before you go anywhere, slide the fingers one down. Yeah? And then inhale, palms forward and up. So you were doing that, right? Whatever fingers on top, just go down like that. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, you're leaning to the left, okay? So again, notice your shoulders. Notice that left sideways. Are you collapsing? Can you lengthen? Okay? And then can you let that shoulders relax? Maybe bend the elbows. Maybe bring the hands forward. Okay? Breathe. Lovely. Inhale, come back into that cactus arm position. And as you exhale, twist to the left, okay? Take a deep breath in there. As you exhale, lean forward, right elbow to your left knee, palms together. You can lower the back knee down if you wish, okay? Inhale to lengthen. Exhaling to twist and breathe. Keep that back leg nice and strong if you can. Fabulous. And then as you breathe out, release your hands down. Go back into downward dog. Have a little goggle. And then bend the knees a little, look forward, take a breath. As you breathe out, step, jump, fly to the front of the mat. And inhale, coming up halfway. Exhale, come all the way up. Inhale, reach up. Exhaling, release. So my class plan is all about this warrior two, dancing warrior, and then we'll do triangle, and we're going to do half knee yet again, but with a difference. Okay, so should we turn this way instead this time? So step your right leg back, okay? And turn to face the long edge of your mat, feet wide, okay? And we're going to turn our right foot in a little bit. We're going to turn our left foot to the front of the mat. Keep the shoulders in line, and we're going to bend our left knee, okay? Now, we're going to do that whole reverse warrior thing, but this time, no hands. So let's inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, hug the feet in, draw the tailbone down. As you breathe in, you're going to lean towards your right leg, cross your right arm in front of your belly, left arm up and over. As you breathe out, you're going to lean towards your front leg, cross your left arm across the belly, right arm up and over, spin the chest up. Inhale, lift up and go back. Again, cross that back arm across the belly. Exhale, come forward, crossing the front arm in front of the belly. One more, inhale, go back. And as you exhale, you're going to come forward and hold it. So if you feel like it's too much to have your left hand floating, go ahead and put your left arm down. But if you feel like you've got it today, you want to work a little harder, reach your left arm forward as well. Hug the feet in, draw the belly in, and spin your chest up a little bit more. And then inhale, come all the way up, straighten that left leg, and turn your... What does it feel like? It's even harder, isn't it? Okay, what's got to work to keep you up?
That's ridiculous.
It's your core. But you're adding all that weight to just by reaching your arms, right? So remember to be careful that you're not collapsing into the lower back. You're pulling the belly, the pelvic floor up, and the feet can really help hug in. And also remember that lengthening of the sideways, the bottom sideways. That will switch on the top sideways, which will help hold you in place instead of everything just collapsing. Okay? So let's keep our left foot slightly turned in. Right foot out, chest to the long edge of the mat. And then we're going to bend our right knee. Inhale, bring the arms to shoulder height. Exhale, hug the feet in, draw your tailbone down. So you already feel the feet working for you. Inhale, lean towards your left leg, cross your left arm in front of the belly. Okay. Exhale, lean towards your right leg, cross your right arm in front of the belly and spin your chest up. Inhale towards the left leg, lengthening the left side of the body. Exhale towards your right leg, lengthening the right side of the body. One more. Inhale back into reverse warrior. And exhale forward into side angle. Now, again, if you feel like today you need to rest your right forearm down, go ahead and rest. If you don't need to do that, keep it up, lengthen your right side base, spin the chest up more, and then reach both arms forward. So think about lengthening. So both arms reaching. And then inhale, press into the feet, come all the way up. And we're going to turn our feet forward again. So make sure the toes are not turned out, they're parallel turning. If anything, they turn slightly in. So don't let them turn out. So think about practicing with awareness, okay? We're going to take our hands behind our back, interlace the fingers. So I want you to think about your heart, like there's a light here, like a headlight at your heart center. When you go forward, don't collapse down. You want that light shining forward for as long as you can. So let's inhale, draw the shoulder blades towards each other, lift the hands away from the back. Exhale, draw the belly in, keep your heart reaching forward as you bend from the hip creases. And then when you feel that's it, I'm not going to go any further, then you can allow everything to soften and lift your hands up a little bit more. Relax the neck. Take the weight towards the front of the feet a little, okay? And hug the feet in towards each other. Breathe. Try to pull your hands as if you're trying to pull them away from each other as well. And then release the hands and use your out breath to slowly come all the way back up. And then you can either heel toe yourself back together, turn to the front. Are we okay? Yeah. Do you want to have a sip of water or anything? So I'm going to quickly show you this most fun thing that we're going to be doing. So we're going to go into same starting position, but we're going to find our way into triangle. And then I want you to think about crunching the lower body and then lengthening it back out just to feel the difference. And then from that, we're going to bend that front knee, okay? We're going to keep the chest still facing outwards, step that back leg in. We're going to reach the bottom hand forward, the other hand come onto the hip, and you lift up into your half moon, and then you're going to maybe take that arm up and over. If you find that's not for you today, I'd like you to put your front hand down on a brick. Yeah? Gemma, please don't do that. Put your front hand down on the brick, okay? So the brick, if you're using it, is going to be a good 6 inches in front of your feet and out to the side, so not directly in front, because if it's here, you've got no chance, okay? Well, yeah, some of you will, but should we do it? Yeah, so should we turn that way this time? Keep swapping around, so turn to your left, and step your feet wide, okay? So remember, have bricks if you want bricks, don't have. And those of you near the camera, choose to fall the other way, please. Step your feet wide, and we're going to turn our left foot in a little, and turn our right foot to the front of the mat. Keep the chest facing the long edge of your mat. Take your left hand to your left hip, bend your right knee a little. Inhale, reach your right arm forward. Exhale, keep reaching, and place the hand below the knee somewhere, okay? Now, as you breathe in, allow the spine to round a little bit. As you breathe out, draw the belly in, scoop your tailbone under, spin your chest up towards the ceiling. And then work that front leg towards straight. Bring your left hand onto your left side ribs, okay? As you breathe in, I want you to dome that side ribs up, collapsing into the right side waist. As you breathe out, lengthen the right side waist and flatten out your ribs. Inhale and dome that up, flattening the right side waist. Exhale and lengthen your right side waist and flattening out the left ribs. And do that one more time. Inhale to gently dome it up. Exhale, lengthen and feel the left side waist working. Okay? Take your left arm up for a moment. Think about spinning your chest up, up, up. Lovely. Now on your next out breath, bring your left hand back onto your left hip, bend your right knee, okay? So if you want to use the brick, your right hand is going to find the brick. If you're not using the brick, you're just going to step that left foot in, keep your chest spinning to the, in front of you still, reach your right arm forward if you're not resting it on the brick, and then push into your right foot, lift your left foot up and flex the foot, okay? And then reach your, if you want to, lift your left arm up towards the front of you. So if you want to, you can take your left arm up and over, keep spinning the chest up, up to the side, chest up. And then when you're ready, lower gently back. And then straighten that front leg and come out. How are we doing? Is that tough? Well done, everybody. Should we do the other side? Yeah, just turn.
Please, please.
Tell you what, turn all the way that way so that it's balanced today. We keep turning you around. Nice and confused. What's up? You okay?
Still got a drink
on. God. Right, feet wide. Okay? We're going to turn our right foot in a little, turn our left foot out. Yeah? And then we're going to bend that left knee a little, right hand onto our hips. Inhale, left arm up. As you exhale, reach that left hand forward and place it somewhere below the knee. Okay? So if you take it too far down and you collapse the spine, I want you to bring it up a little bit. You want to be able to spin the chest up. But for now, let's inhale round the spine, stick our bum out behind us. Exhale, scoop your belly in, scoop your tailbone under, spin the chest up, and then work that front leg towards straight. Okay? We're going to bring our right hand onto our right rib cage. Okay? And as you breathe in, dome that up, collapse into the left side of your waist. As you breathe out, lengthen the left side waist and flatten out the dome. Inhale and dome it up. Exhale and straighten out. So you're not turning your chest up and down. Inhale and shorten your right side waist. You're not turning your chest down. Just shorten this and dome this up into my hand. Exhale, lengthen the bottom side waist and lengthen the top. Lovely. And you can take your top arm up. Breathe. Think about what we're doing next. When you're ready, you're going to bring that right hand onto your right hip, bend your left knee, and if you're working with brick, put your left hand down onto a brick. Step your right foot in a little bit, keep your chest turning to the right, okay? And then reach your left arm forward, lift your right leg up, keep drawing the belly in, and then maybe reach your right arm overhead towards the front as well. Keep that back foot really strong. Imagine that you're pushing it against the wall. Put the hands up. Yeah, no, don't fall into it. And then when you lower, go back into Warrior Two stance. That's it. Lovely. And then straighten the leg, release the hands, and we're going to heel toe ourselves back to the front. How are we doing? Shall we hip circle? It's nice. Hip circles. Voila. Yeah. You know, you might feel this a little bit because there's a lot of work in what is called the QL, your quadratus lumborum, which gets worked a lot in any of these side bending processes, especially when you're not using your hands. Okay? So, have you hip circled the other way? Enjoy the hip circles. Shall we squat down today? I haven't done a squat in a while. I don't even know if I can do it. I get surprises every day with my body at the moment. So, right, take our feet wide, turn our toes out, okay? Hands onto the hips, take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, bum, back, knees bent, lower down. Oh, yeah, it's fine. Now, press the elbows. Press the elbows into your inner knees and lift the chest up. Yeah. And then sit down. So if you want to bring the knees down first, that's fine. You can sit down. Extend the legs out. Extend the legs out in front of you, okay? And we're going to bend our right knee. Have I lost Mike already?
Sorry.
Not done, darling, not done.
Not
quite. Right. So you want to have roughly a hand's width between your right foot and your left thigh. So not so close together. And flex your left foot. You're going to bring your right shoulder or elbow to the inside of that right knee, okay? And try not to drop the knee out, hug the knee into your arm. And then take your left hand behind you. And as you breathe in, lengthen the spine. As you breathe out, spin your chest to the left. And then hold it there and breathe. Think about pressing the arm and the leg against each other so the muscles are working. And then take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, turn to the front. One more little of these side bendings. So yeah, you're going to feel it. You're going to drop the right knee down. Now, if you just keep the knee where it is, you're going to be facing front. I want you to face sideways. So pull that right heel up towards your right groin. So you're opening out to the side. Okay, I'm going to turn this way so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so you're sitting facing in between your two knees. Yeah? Yeah? We're good? What's up? You okay? Okay. Cross your arms. Flex your left foot. Feel free to bend the left knee a little bit so you can dig the heel down more. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, keep that left sideways really long as you lean to the left and spin your chest up. Okay? Now you can uncross and bring your arms into cactus arm position. And you might find that you can rest your left elbow onto your left leg. And your head into your left hand, And you might want to reach your right arm straight over. Some of you will be able to take your left hand to your left foot and then take your right hand to your left foot, and you're going to spin the chest up. Okay, so think about the chest spinning up rather than down. Beautiful. And then inhale, come all the way up, hands behind your head. This might be horrendous, so you might want to put your hands down, okay? So take a deep breath in. You're still facing in between your two knees, okay? And as you breathe out, reach your heart forward, and then go just to the place before you collapse and smack your face to the floor, stop, and hold it, and breathe. And then inhale, come back up, release the hands, okay? And extend your right leg forward, bring your left foot in so that there's about a hand's width between the right thigh and the left foot, and the foot is close to your bum, yeah? And then you're bringing either your left elbow or left shoulder to the inside, okay? And hug the leg into the arm. Take your right hand back behind you. I don't know. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, draw the ribs in and spin your chest to the right and hold it there and breathe. Nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, turn back to the front. Okay? And again, remember, we're going to lower our left knee down, but then don't keep the foot there. Pull it back. Okay, so pull your foot back so that your knee goes back behind you and you're sitting facing in between the two knees. And then we're going to cross our arms across the chest again. Take a deep breath in. If you need to straighten it, just straighten it. As you breathe out, we're going to aim our shoulder towards our leg, but can you lengthen out that right side waist a little bit so you're not collapsing? And then you can open the arms, rest your right elbow down if it feels good. You can rest your head into your hand. If it doesn't feel good, don't force it, okay? And again, some of you might be able to reach both hands for the feet, spin the chest up, up, up. If it doesn't feel good, don't do it. Do what feels good, right? Breathe. And then inhale, come all the way up. Keep your right foot really active. You're still facing down between the two knees. Hands behind your head, take a deep breath in. Exhale, draw the belly in and begin to come forward with a long spine first, and then you can relax the neck when you are not going any further. So a little bit more control, a little bit more active. And then inhale, come all the way up. Last one of these, and then we'll do a bridge pose quickly. So we're going to take our legs wide. Legs wide. So you can turn sideways and have your feet on the mat if you like, or stagger yourself, whatever works, okay? Flex the feet. Now, feel free to bend the knees, right? You can even do that, okay, if you want to. And it's just a little kinder for the hamstrings. But if you don't need to, you don't need to, okay? Flex the feet so everything is active here, okay? Have that sense of pulling the feet in a little bit. Take your hands behind your head. Take a nice deep breath in, have your hands on the floor for you. And as you breathe out again, we're going to slowly come forward. And then when you kind of like feel, okay, hold on there a moment, take another breath when you're ready. And maybe as you exhale, you can go a little further forward. And then when you feel like that's enough, then you just stay there, okay? So that there's strength in the pose rather than just collapsing into it. Inhale, slowly come all the way up. Take your hands underneath your knees. Bring them up. Okay. And then we're just going to have a quick twist before we do bridge pose. So sit comfortably, legs together if it feels comfortable. If not, keep them apart. Okay. And then we're going to wrap our left arm across the knee. So just left arm across one knee. Okay. And right hand goes behind you. And inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, twist to the right. Give it a little wriggle here. That's not a little wriggle, that. Nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, go all the way to the other side, wrapping your right arm across your legs, left hand behind. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale into twist and a little wriggle. Nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, turn back to the front. Actually, I've kind of change my mind about bridge. Do you want bridge or do you want a forward bend, do you think?
Bridge.
What, how does your lower back feel? Some of you will want bridge, some of you want lower back.
Lying down, down.
We're there, nearly there. We have to do a bit of meditation. You can lie down first if you want, okay? So those of you who prefer a forward bend right now, like I actually feel my body wants a forward bend, you're going to extend the legs out, feel free to bend the knees. If you wanted a bridge, go ahead and do a bridge. It's totally fine. Yeah, you do what, remember, because we're working with awareness, you're going to start to feel that the body wants something and it might not be what I want your body to do. So if you're doing seated forward bend, flex the feet. Bend the knees if you need to. Take a deep breath in, lengthen. And as you breathe out, you're coming forward. And then when you think, that's it, I'm not going any further, you relax the neck, drop everything and breathe. Okay? If you're in bridge, think about pressing down into the feet. Okay? And then drawing out your elbows a little closer underneath you, pushing into the arms and breathe. And then if you're in bridge or wheel, you lower down and just stay there, rock the knees side to side. If you're in seated forward, then come on up. Okay? You might want to just gently turn side to side here as well. Okay. And then we're going to get some warm layers on and we're going to do our Satanama meditation, but this time we're going to do it with the breath. We're not going to chant out loud, we're going to work it with the breath, okay? So make sure you're warm and comfortable so that once we're done with this, we can lie down and relax, can't we? Yeah, I'm just gonna go and turn the light off once I've got this one, because I'm not walking on this floor barefoot.
So you remember Satanama, Sa is first finger to thumb, Ta is second finger to thumb, Na is third finger to thumb, and Ma is your last finger to thumb. So if you want to sit up against the wall, please do. Okay? We need to be really comfortable. If you want to sit on a brick, sit on a brick. What we're going to do, okay, is we're going to try breathing in for one round of Satanama. And then we're going to breathe out for one round of Satanama to begin with. And then you have options. You can either breathe in for one round, hold for one round, breathe out for one round, hold for one round. Or you could just simply breathe in for one round, breathe out for two rounds without the breath retention. This isn't, you're better off breathing in for one round, breathing out for two rounds. Don't do the breath retention, okay? So if you're doing the breath retention, it's equal length, yeah? In, hold, out, hold. We're clear? Yeah? Cool.
So many options.
Well, she's pregnant. She's not going to be holding a breath.
Yeah, I'm in for all
of me. Oh, well, you can do that same one because it's very calming. Very relaxing. So sitting nice and tall. And relax your hands down. Close your eyes now. And just start to become aware of the breath. Become aware of your whole being. Coming back home to yourself. And you know, the breath will tell you what you really want really right now. Okay, so let's start with the normal Satanama. Breathing in for one round of Satanama. Breathing out for one round of Satanama. You go for it, your own breath. And when you feel ready, you can either breathe in for a round, breathe out for two rounds, or you can breathe in, hold, breathe out, hold, one round each. Go for it.
after your next out breath, come back to breathing in for one round, breathing out for one round with no breath retention. And after your next out breath, let the mantra go, relax the hands and breathe normally. And once again, notice how you feel. Notice the state of your mind. And it might not be calm because sitting is not comfortable. Just become aware. Because with awareness, we can create change. And then when you're ready to breathe out next time, lower the chin down, blink the eyes open. And then find your way into Shavasana, into your relaxation. So if you feel like you want to wriggle it out a little bit, once you lie down, you do that. Okay? If you feel you want to bend your knees, you bend your knees. Maybe some of you might want to roll the back of the mat and place your head on that. Some of you might want a block to put under your head. You can just shout and then you ring it. Some of you, I remember. I'm sorry, you don't have to shout. So get yourself as comfortable as you can. Okay? And then let's take one really big, deep breath in. And if you can hold it, hold it. Notice if you're holding tension anywhere. And when you're ready to breathe it out, let all of that tension go. Soften all of those areas. Okay. And then just allow the breath to flow in and out freely and softly. Let the breath be soft and relaxed and natural. And I'm just going to mention areas of your body. I want you to take your awareness to those areas and imagine you're placing little tea lights there. So they will be your little light of awareness. Okay. So take your attention to the crown of the head. Let that be soft. Place that little tea light there. Into the center of your head. Place another light there. Then down to your throat. Place a little tea light of awareness there. And then one on your shoulder, right elbow, right wrist, right palm. Over to the left shoulder, left elbow, left wrist, left palm. Over to your heart center, right at the center of your chest. Place the light of awareness there and invite that area to be soft. Down to the center of your upper belly. Move your awareness down to the center of your pelvic bowl. Down to the center of your pelvic floor. And place a light of awareness at your right hip, right knee, right ankle, right foot, to the left hip, left knee, left ankle, left foot. And see your whole body like a constellation of stars with lights everywhere. And just for a moment, rest in that. And then start to encourage the breath in to be a little deeper, the breath out to be a little longer. And as you breathe in, imagine your light shining out into the world, all those little lights of yours. And as you breathe out, draw in a little bit, soften everything a little bit more. So breathing in, let your beautiful light spread into the world. Breathing out and draw that light in a little bit, because we need to draw in sometimes in order to shine our light. Okay. And then let go of that imagery and take a moment to check in with yourself, see how you're feeling. Let's take a deep breath of love and gratitude in and hold it for a moment. Allow love and gratitude to flow to every cell of your amazing being. And sign love and gratitude out to all beings on earth. And then start to make little movements, any movement actually that feels good, because you've got all that awareness now for what your body needs. You don't need me to tell you what to do, okay? But if you're not sure, go ahead and do a big stretch, okay? But if you're not, if you have other things you want to be doing, do that, okay? And then everybody, when you feel ready, bring the knees into the chest, give yourself a big cuddle, rocking gently side to side. And then when you feel really ready, roll to one side, come on up, and we'll finish with our one ohm together. So once you're up, sit nice and tall, right, bring your hands to your heart center, eyes can be softly opened or closed, and take a nice deep breath in. Next time, gently bow your head down to your heart. Thank yourself for being amazing. Om Shanti, thank you.